Brother Lewis is our chairman of deacons. He's going to help with the Lord's Supper. And before we give you the bread, the body of Christ, the symbolic body of Christ, he's going to lead us in the word of prayer.
Father, we thank you with an joy in reminding what Jesus did for us. We ask that you, with this reminder, that you help us remember this every day. In Jesus' name, amen.
And you can see on the screen the 1 Corinthians passage. That's the passage that I'll be using as we read those things that Paul wrote a long time ago. And one other little detail, our bread is also gluten-free. It's a darker one if you need that.
Thank you.
had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Let's joyfully do that.
As we celebrate the Lord's Supper, we thank you for the blood you shed on the cross. 1 Corinthians 11:25 says, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Lord, as you instructed, let us examine ourselves. May we do that now as we drink this cup. In Jesus' name.
What is amazing about this is that Jesus was celebrating the Passover Supper with his disciples. And he changed the meaning. He said, this is the blood of the new covenant. And then Paul in 1 Corinthians 11 says, do this in remembrance of me, but also for the coming of the Lord. You'll do this until he comes. So the understanding of that is we will do this until he comes, and then in heaven there's another supper called the marriage supper of the Lamb, where the bride and the groom come together, and what he started is completion. And so until Jesus comes, we're going to do this, and we're going to remind ourselves that he's coming again. So as the Bible says, drink this, all of you, for as often as you drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord until he comes. Let's do that together. One other little detail that I always mention to you is these cups are disposable, so you can put them in the pew rack, or you can take them with you, which I recommend that you do, and put them in a prominent place in your house. I usually put it on my desk in my office or on the dresser in our bedroom to remind me what I just did on Sunday. So let's stand together. We're going to have a word of prayer, and we're going to be dismissed in a little bit. But I want to pray with you one more time, and then we have a little instruction about our business meeting that Jeremy will give you. But pray that God would bless you in every way this week as you go out. And so let's just pray together and just thank him again. Father, with simple thanksgiving for not only reconciling us and forgiving us and taking away the wrath of God that we deserve and placing it on Jesus, but also for buying us. We're not our own. We don't belong to ourselves anymore. Thank you for that message, Lord, but most of all, thank you for your love. As we go out this week, remind us continually that you love us, and let us love other people as you loved us. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.